it, who doesn't just accept it, because I am young and they are very experienced people here. It's not the way. David was the youngest, but when he saw Goliath, he saw an opportunity to praise God. Amen. He didn't give in and say, "It doesn't go like that." Amen. Determined people are people who says, "I will stand, even if it looks like I'm taking chances, but I know my God will stand. We will fight for me." The second dimension of my 3D is diligence. Diligence. Diligent people are precise and always strive to be the best. Diligent people are people that are not lazy. Diligent people are not people who are not just doing things for so long. Are people who stand to make sure that whatever I do will represent who I am. Some people are very good at singing in the choir. When they worship, they cry. They love God with all their heart. They hate their books. I hate. Yes, it's possible. Focus. You are here to start.
Amen.
For you to get there, be diligent. For you to get there, be resilient. For you to get there, strive to be the best at all times. Diligent people are people who make sure that whatever they do represent who they are. The Bible says in the book of Romans 12, verse 11, be not slow in your work, but be quick in spirit as the some other versions will say, be diligent in your work. And don't be slothful. Representing God in everything that you do. Diligence. Yes, you can be smart and humble at the same time. Let everything that you do show that you are inspired by God. You are the child of God. At least try to make sure that whatever you do, it is the best that you can do. My third dimension. The third dimension is discipline. Discipline is policing or guarding your own self against your own destructive self. People are people who recognize their weaknesses and then stand firm to make sure that they don't bring them down. Disciplined people are people who know who they are and know that I am not perfect at everything, but this one, I will make sure that I look after it. Disciplined people. Discipline is policing or guarding against our own destructive self. Unless you are able to control yourself or lead yourself, you will not be able to lead anyone. You will be your own downfall. If you have not mastered to know who you are, I know most of you are coming out from home for the first time, and this will be time to discover yourself.
Amen.
As you discover yourself, know that you cannot be everything. In some of the things you run short, and in the areas where you run short, guard yourself against those. Your weaknesses are the things that makes you to make mistakes every time. This thing just makes you to always keep doing wrong. It's as though Paul in 7:14 of Romans says, whatever I want to do, I find myself not able to do. Everything that I find myself wanting to do, I fail to do because I've been sold to the sinful self who is himself. The Apostle Paul says in 1 Corinthians 9, verse 27, but I keep on disciplining my body, making itself mean serve him, so that he may not, he himself who preached to others, may not be found wanting after having preached to others. Don't find yourself having contributed so much for people to be blessed, when at the end of the day, and the end of the year, and the end of the years, you won't be blessed. Discipline yourself. Keep yourself on guard. Deal with that demon within you. Put it under your control. And be charge of your, and take charge of your life. We may rise on our feet. There's no more others. For your life and promises. It has started. He who brought you here knew that you will be here in this time, if not at the same. The Lord who saw you from where you were and brought you amongst these people have a purpose about your life. He needs you to make an impact. He needs your life to change other people's lives. But the onus is with you.
Give me your email, that food will go back to where it came from.
are still here. Hallelujah. The day that we have been talking about ever since up until now, it finally came. Hallelujah. Amen. Our first attempt. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
You look like you are not happy. Look, the ancestors, they left. The chest that which they belong to the chest which belong to the first attempt are now empty. To the ancestors, I mean, they are now empty. So now it's your time to enjoy. You understand? The executive. Can we all give a round of applause to our executive? Yes, executive, thank you very much for the wonderful opportunity. I see our VC is busy looking at our BC dancing in his phone. We appreciate you for the wonderful opportunity that you gave us as the FOC to host this wonderful event. It was not an easy job. Yes, I see our coordinator is coming. Let's give our coordinator a round of applause as he comes in. Come on, somebody give our coordinator a round of applause as he comes in. You can do better than that. You can do better than that. You can do better than that. Hallelujah. Yes. That's Dr. Brown, our branch coordinator. Amen. I was still saying the executive, thank you very much. It was not an easy job. Yesterday we finished at 11:30, still trying to fight to make sure that this event is a success with SCC grilling some of us, hallelujah. But finally it came to pass, hallelujah. Yes, and to my wonderful crew, can the FOC just stand up and you see them? These are the people who make sure that this event becomes a success. Come on, somebody, come on, somebody, come on, somebody. So that table was not clapping. Eh? That table and that table over there, they were not clapping. I don't know, you will see what to do with them. Oh, hallelujah. And I would like to appreciate the man of God and his wife, Pastor Shuguri, for gracing us this evening. Can we give a round of applause to you? It was late, but they made it. Thank God for you. Hallelujah. And also I'd like to appreciate two of my friends. Pat, I don't know where he's seated, but I know he is somewhere here. He's outside. Oh, yes. But he went outside. He needed some oxygen. Yes, so he went outside. Thank you very much. He's been a great asset through the organizing of this whole event and going up and down. And also Sister Zanele in Absentia, she's not here. Thank you very much. Going on to our first interim, you should know that many are the plans in a man's heart, but the Lord's purpose will prevail. So people might be planning a lot of things for you, but keep on trusting God. Some of us are still here ever since I think I got here 2012, and even now I'm still here. And it's all by the grace of God. Thank you. Some of you, where you're coming from at home, the
There's no one who's going to be taking care of you. There's no one who's going to be giving you money every month. But let me tell you this, keep on trusting God. Do not sell yourself cheap just for you to get food in your room. There is God to trust. From 2012 up until now, it's not because I was not studying or doing anything, but I have been studying every day, studying, working, in all those ways. Hallelujah. But God kept you. God is going to keep you even up until you finish your degree. Do not sell yourself cheap for small things. Hallelujah. That opportunity, it's only for these 3 years or these 4 years. Use it effectively. Hallelujah. And don't let the fire that which you came with from home be quenched. Sister Mato mentioned something here, that the brothers are here. Yes, they are here. And the sisters are here. Those who have been here long enough. And you came from home, you will find them here. Some of them you will go and leave them here, just like others came and left us here, and you came again. Hallelujah. Yes. And now I actually want to call on these people. You see, we just thought of this now, but we would have done that, and we're still gonna do it again. Can I please have Favor Baloyi and Priscilla Mauta or Mautu, you will correct me, stand on their feet. Can you please come here? Give them a round of applause, please. Give them a round of applause. Come on, come on, come on, come on, somebody. Come on. Don't be so jealous. You know some people are so jealous to clap their hands. Come on, give them a round of applause! Yes. As you see them like this,
yes.
I received a Facebook inbox from Priscilla yesterday. I did not know her, and she was telling me news, you know. So, as it's like this, you can see the man of God is ready. Where you are, as we are about to give the man of God his opportunity that which he asks for in our first entering.
Look at your jealous, look at your jealous.
Bazalane, these are the best dressed of the night. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Not just a little bit, I'm going to tell you,